of mine. That's Sheik? Is he going to go Sheik?
Interesting. Okay. Maybe he's thinking like, okay, well, you're not playing at full power. I'm not going to play at full power. But I know Charlie has a lot of faith in Sheik, and he's been looking for new setups and new ways to, like, either set up into Bouncing Fish or set up into Needles Bouncing Fish. That fair is going to be a really big thing for Sheik to really look at, actually.
Mm-hmm. And it's a Melee Glory Day battle right now.
Mm-hmm. We're going to see some tech chases, too, very soon, probably. Just kidding. No.
Oh, man. This damage output coming in from Falco, though, it is something to behold. Mm-hmm. And if he gets him with an up tilt bear, I'm going to be pretty upset.
Yeah, I feel like just in general, Falco wins the trades most of the time, but once you get the combos like that, then Sheik can do a really good job of keeping up and getting that damage output.
No.
We were looking for it. maybe it's only super true on Meta Knight. Like, that was because it looked like he air dodged out of that. But yep, just try to go for that drag down up air. I believe to get the proper way to do the drag down up air, you have to start it after the second hit. Either that or you have to get 4 hits out of the up air so that your advantage on hit, if I recall correctly.
Yeah. Either way, it looks sick. But and here's another up tilt. But now Charlie definitely out of the percentage for the up tilt bear. And now Larry's going to have to find another way. Probably just go for a smooth, like a clean backer. Or just kill him with down tilt. And that move on its own is very strong. Charlie trying to get a tech chase out of the bear with the down smash.
Yeah, a lot of Sheik's moves start to send into tumble at these high percents, so you can try to find a tech chase into like a smash attack. And wow, 53% already looking a little bit rough, and try to find an air dodge read, but still nothing coming to fruition.
Yeah, it looks like Charlie's kind of having a bit of a hard time trying to get these confirms. Oh, there's a down tilt to up bear though. That's a confirm, and that looked clean.
Yeah, that'll finally do it at around 100%. And he's Sheik, so he can start off these combos very soon. There we go, goes for the forward throw into the fair. He loses the trade a little bit, but he's starting to extend it back, and he's trying to maintain his advantage position.
Yeah, and there's forward tilts coming in from Charlie. Trying to reset into fairs and back again to forward tilts. And that's kind of what Charlie's game plan is. He wants to get you with the forward tilt, he wants to get you with the bear, and then he wants to kind of like move, like bounce you back and like all the way down to the end of the blast zone. And like once you're off stage, it's going to be really tough because Sheik's off stage game is so strong.
Okay, is that fair?
Yeah, but
the ledge trapping, yeah, using Sheik's movement to his advantage. Oh, he didn't go for Neil's bouncing fish.
Yeah, but that looked really nice if he was going to go for another one. Man, that if that up, to, if that forward tilt, if Larry did not DI away, he was done. Mm-hmm. Oh, trying to get him with the B reverse on the needles, and I saw an up tilt. If that killed, and that wasn't the bear, that was up air that time.
Yeah,
he's got those mix-ups.
Yeah, Sheik's a light character, so she's gonna die to a lot of stuff like that as well. Mm-hmm. Oh, catches the spot dodge, spamming, and picks him up again with the up tilts. Gets those up airs juggling off the top again. Every time Larry has gotten an opening, he's gotten at least 50% because Falco's so good at juggling these fastballers.
And there's that down tilt to up air. Getting that, cleaning out that stock very nicely. Oh, fair into the laser.
Trying to find that forward smash. Not quite finding anything, though. Mm-hmm. Oh, up tilts. Okay. I see you, Charlie, going with the bouncing fish to finish off the combo, but Larry trying to elicit a roll out of him does not quite get it, though.
Mm-hmm. And now they're both looking for an opportunity to like open each other out. And if you watch them both, they're playing a really nice grounded game. Like, you don't really see these two players. They're not short hopping as much as the games before.
Right. Charlie trying to elicit a reaction with that dash back. He got the directional air dodge. He didn't get anything afterwards, though. Larry just going with a low safe recovery.
Mm-hmm. And like, I feel like they're not doing these short hops because of how strong both these characters have as an anti-air. Mm-hmm. Falco's up tilt so strong, and so is Sheik's forward tilt. And
Needles forced low, but he still saved his jump. Back off stage one more time. Down tilt's not connecting. The up tilt, I'm so scared of, and you can see he's looking for it, mm-hmm. but he gets that grab one more time. Put him backstage.
Very scary. Oh, there's the up smash. Nice. That wasn't confirmed. That was a read for coming in for Charlie.
Yeah. The up smash will reach all of the platform stages as far as I know, except for maybe Town and City as far as I know.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a good tech chase option, especially when you're putting them in that platform situation.
Mm-hmm. And, yeah, it's a really good. It has a pretty good reach, but And as you said, Pokemon Stadium 2's like platform's just a little tad bit high.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. Going to Battlefield. Let's see if the change of scenery is good for Larry or if Charlie's going to continue. And he's opening up immediately with that combo, but unfortunately, at those low percents, it looks like it quite worked. Able to air dodge through.
Mm-hmm. Larry getting him with the rapid jab. Oh, the parry.
Ooh, and I like that too. The down tilt low profiled with whatever Larry was trying to do. Oh, and the fair into Bouncing Fish. That's kind of the new confirmed besides Nair to Bouncing Fish. Oh!
Recovering to ledge. Very smart coming up from Charlie. Oh, there's a jab block in the up smash.
Yep. We've seen it in Smash 4, and it's still there. Mm-hmm. Very great stuff.
Ooh. Larry trying to get some reaction from Charlie, trying to get him with the down air.
Mm-hmm. Potential chase. Not going to get anything, though. The falling up air into the dare. Larry really trying to look for something, and now Charlie's like, oh, shoot, I'm on the top platform against Falco, and the up tilt to...
Up tilt to bear. Yeah. Larry's favorite combo.
I mean, to be fair, it might be the only combo to kill. I'm not 100% sure.
It's very clean. Yeah. Very solid.
Very reliable. I'm sure there's other situational combos Falco has that I can't think off the top of my head.
But. Hey, but Charlie did a down tilt to up air, so that's a confirm in itself.
Yep. Both these two going dead even in their stocks, basically. But here we go. Gets that grab. Not able to follow up, though.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the air dodge a little far, but there's the nair. Weak hit a nair, but he couldn't really get much off of it. He already used his bouncing fish.
Yeah. He could have kind of potentially gone for a dare and then put in a last stock situation or maybe try to trade with the Firebird, but maybe he was feeling a little scared about it.
Yeah, that air dodge back into the ledge. Very smart coming up from Larry. And the landing hitbox of fair put Charlie in an awkward spot. That dare was ambitious. And Charlie going in now.
Yeah, I love the little movement, too. You saw him do Bouncing Fish, and then he did it so quick, it's so hard to miss. So you can do a needle cancel in the air, and then keep your air options. It's just able to keep up with your movement so well. That's why you don't normally see Sheik's fully charged needles, just because you have the movement option with the B reverses and the wave bounces as well to help you land and to move around the stage.
Yeah, both players looking for an opening way to open each other. Larry actually fishing out those up tilts. Oh, he just went right back down with the dare, challenging him. Oh, and he got him with a forward smash.
Yeah, great spacing. He knew that he probably was looking for some kind of punish like that, but it didn't quite come to fruition, and he just spaced right outside of it and got himself a great combo.
He didn't kill with that? Unfortunate. Oh. Sheik needs a buff.
That was like one pixel away, dude. Uh-huh. Like, seriously.
Oh, the double up air to fair, getting him a 44%. Oh, but he... couldn't challenge the up B. That move still has some invincibility.
Yeah, you gotta be careful on that. Pick them up with up air. Try to get a dare afterwards. Mm-hmm. Not quite working out. Dare in, or excuse me, down tilt to fair, not quite connecting either.
Mm-hmm. And now, man, Sheik's fair only doing 4%. Mm-hmm. And I feel like he needs to get him at a little higher to kind of get these resets going, you know? If anything earlier, it kind of puts him in. I feel like it's a negative on hit sometimes.
Right. Okay, the forward tilt. I like how he did the pivot cancel forward tilt too, to get some extra movement.
No. Oh, no. Oh, no. Not the up tilt. Not the up tilt to bear.
I'm so upset.
Up tilt to bear. The combo of a century. Mm-hmm. Falcos will hear it forever. Man. And Larry putting in work with it. Taking a sip of his drink.
Alrighty.
And Charlie is dedicated to this character. Putting his potential. Oh, that's 1-1.
All right, Charlie takes off the jacket. Takes off the weights. We're going to. It's not really Sheikville anymore, but used to be Sheikville.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't have the moving platform, so it's not as clean. Mm-hmm. And down. Oh, I like that. He turns it around so he could put Larry into offstage situation.
Yeah, that was so quick, too. I'm surprised. Ooh, the directional air dodge catching Larry. I feel like this is where Sheik is supposed to be like the strongest, the ledge trapping, using that movement and that pressure to be able to elicit reactions and then get the punish off of it. It's just kind of difficult with Sheik in general to be able to put yourself in that situation in the first place because all your combos kind of don't work sometimes.
Mm-hmm. There's a rapid jab getting getting Larry off stage, getting him with the Nair to bouncing fish. This is really low. Oh no, he went for the downbeat, but it didn't beat out the Firebird.
Yeah, unfortunate.
No, please stop.
Not too much room on the stage that time around, but maybe if he gets another one. Oh, the tech chase! Yo! Catches the bad DI too on that tech roll.
And it looked like, I feel like Larry might have pressed the button a bit too early, and that might have killed him.
Oh my god, he air dodged through. Thank god. And he didn't get the frame trap either.
Scary, scary. And Larry air dodging back onto the onto the ledge. But Charlie throwing out these forward tilts, and these are looking really clean. Two back airs, but only 29%, even though he hit him like with a six-hit combo.
Yeah. Well, I mean, Sheik's got the fast data, so that's kind of like the trade-off for it. But wow, scoops him up back with the down tilt. Another edge guard position. What's he going to go for?
And waiting him out. And there's the needle to forward tilt. That's actually super clean. Ooh. And Larry coming back on the stage with the aggressive forward air.
They get up attack and catch the end lag of that down tilt. That fair putting him off stage one more time. Oh, and I like that, the fade back. And Sheik has that great recovery still, so she can afford to just do fade back and just avoid whatever attempted edge guard he's trying to go for. But the down tilt finally going to take out the stock.
Mm-hmm. And those great reactions coming in from Larry. You know, like, he was kind of reading some type of option, but he was kind of right in the perfect position for the roll get up.
Yeah.
And there's the up tilt, not going to kill.
He low profiled that fair and got the trade with the down tilt and another potential kill option.
Oh no. Is this the awkward percent for Sheik now?
Yeah.
It's like now Charlie's confirms aren't as convenient.
Yeah. That at this point I feel like you can maybe send them to tumble for like tech chase situations, but it looks like,
oh man, that looked like it could have confirmed.
Mm-hmm.
Needles bouncing fish. And actually, Charlie up his whole stock against Larry.
Yeah, on game three. Good place for that to happen.
Mm-hmm. Charlie getting back onto stage, but Larry reading the option with the reading the neutral getup, getting him with the grab. And now Charlie it feels like he's hitting him so much. We only got 8%.
Yeah.
Man, Sheik's damage output a little lackluster, and the forward tilt in there, negative on hit. Larry was able to punish him with the jabs.
All right, got him at the ledge, though.
Mm-hmm.
He's making it back, but he's trying to find that opening, but I feel like Larry's just being a little bit more aware of it this time around. Mm-hmm. But that time, he's going to get caught by that up tilt and the jabs, send him back down.
Ooh, man, double down tilt. He just throws it out there, but it didn't kill, oddly enough. And there's the fair. That's going to take out the stock, though.
Alrighty, last stock situation for game three.
Mm-hmm.
We first start off with the falling up airs into the back air.
Yep, forward tilt to fair. To fair yet again. Larry off stage. Oh, caught him with the down tilt. Not going to kill. But Larry retaliating with a big damage combo of his own.
Man, he just has like one nair and all of a sudden Sheik's at 35%. Like, damn, dude, you didn't work for that compared to my Sheik.
No, not going to kill. Pretty close, though. There's a back air. There's up tilt to up air. And, man, if you get caught with an up tilt from Falco, you are eating a lot of stuff.
Yeah,
you're eating a lot of damage.
It's such a good move, man. Like, who needs throws? You just up tilt, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, but here we go. The up tilt, the forward tilt, sends it back up, but not able to combo into the up air. Even if it did connect, I don't know if it'll kill. No jump from Larry. Going to be sent back down. He makes it back in time.
The bare maximum. If he was like half a second too late, he was done. But there's the down tilt affair. Larry getting the phantasm, and there's the up air, not going to connect. But he frame traps him with the back air. And there's the bouncing fish. And that's going to be the game.
Oh, man, that was so clutch from Charlie, actually. He got the up air, it air dodged through, and he knew that he was going to be able to try and escape that with that again. So he got a frame trap with that back air. Caught him as a bad TI, too, when he was trying to drift away, and that was set up for the perfect position for that.
Mm-hmm. And Charlie messed it up the first time, but the second time he did it, looking really good.
Alrighty. So Charlie finally up the game.
Mm-hmm.
We're still sticking with it.
Still sticking with it. Dedication. He said he was going Falco all day.
Mm-hmm.
Drinking and playing Falco. I gotta do.
Yeah. All right, here we go.
And we're going to FD this time. Actually, this now seems like Sheik's best stage.
Yeah. Except for maybe you don't get the platform sections. Wow, Larry with these air dodges. And Charlie
oh no.
was so good at keeping up with it. And wow, what a crucial zero to death right there.
Mm-hmm. And like, it was the perfect bouncing fish. It was really hard to tech. Larry could have teched it, but you have to have the reactions of a deity.
Yeah, I mean, you have to mix up the timing too on the bouncing fish as well. You have to keep that in consideration. So that was just great overall from Charlie. Took it and knew exactly how to capitalize.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man, that fair not being able to cross up and Larry just grabbing him out of it. Charlie has full needles on deck, and Larry, he's no fear in this man's heart. He just goes for the dare.
Oh, and the pivot cancel forward tilt again, just getting that little extra boost that he needs in the spacing to be able to open up Larry's Falco.
Yep, and double fair, and there's the needles. Oh, Larry went a little low, and he went for the dare, and he caught him. And then Charlie the King's laughing. I saw that smirk.
Yeah. he's enjoying it.
Yeah.
He didn't even need the needles into the dare. He just did it straight up against that Firefox recovery.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and Larry chasing him down with that up tilt. But he kind of fell out of it that time.
Oh, man, every time he goes for Firebird, I'm scared now. Like, mm-hmm. He's a sitting duck, and then there's another dare. And he's up a stock, too, so you know he's going to be a guaranteed kill. But let's see what happens here.
Mm-hmm. Up airs are going to happen. Larry's pushing up on that on his directional stick, and it is doing wonders for him. How much damage he's getting. That up tilt, back air. What?
Why is this game even now?
I didn't think that one would kill.
Hey, man.
He was on the other side of the stage.
I know. This Falco, man. What do you expect? But anyways, here we go. Oh, the trades. All of a sudden, Larry brought this back. I feel like... no discredit to Larry at all, but I feel like Charlie had to work so hard just as the character Sheik to get these really early kills, and all of a sudden we're back to even.
Yeah, the damage output, and now Larry's winning.
Yeah, I know. The life of Falco, or Sheik, man. Am I?
Oh,
oh
wait, no
way.
Stop.
Oh, my God.
Up tilt, up air, no way.
Yeah. You know, I was talking to Charlie about this because I played Sheik for a little bit before I dropped her because for obvious reasons. And playing Sheik is a constant state of, yo, man, I'm so freaking good at this game, into, yo, man, I'm so freaking bad at this game. It could happen within stocks, too. You're just like, damn, dude, what happened?
I'm so good at this game.
Like Charlie commanded the lead so well on those first two stocks, and then Larry's just like, okay, let's up tilt back here.
Let me get these quick confirms.
Yeah, man. Oh, boy.
I'm going to catch you jumping, get you with the up tilt.
Yeah. Not to discredit Larry at all. It's not just brainless up tilt back air. Like, that's a hard move to land. Like, I won't lie. It's just kind of a meme because he's been landing it so well this entire, time he's been on stream.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. Game 5. We're on FD. Mm-hmm. See how this goes.
Yep. So, we got Nair to... Yeah. Rapid jab. And now he's just getting him a few times with it. He doesn't really need to get all too much damage because once he's able to get him with a grab or up tilt, you're going to eat a lot of percent.
Oh, doesn't get the forward tilt the right direction, but there's a little cooldown on left, so he can still kind of buffer the next one and be able to catch that. And just like that, Larry was not able to escape that. But another up tilt back air.
Yeah, not going to kill, a little low in terms of percentage this time. Oh, that was a good read coming in from Larry, but it was a little early, and he got the late hit of it.
Mm-hmm. Thought that was true, gets that reverse back air. Oh, yeah. Doesn't catch a ledge option, though. Now Larry's got a chance. Wow, that's what down throw looks like. He, shoots you on the ground.
Yeah, no, he, steps on your face, on your chest, and it shoots you in the face.
Man, that's gangster as heck. All right, here we go. Oh, doesn't get anything off of it, though.
Frame traps. Oh, and there's the down smash read, getting him on that roll getup.
Yep, it does have a lot of power to it, so if you can catch it. I don't know, I like that. Using the needles to solicit Larry to go further out.
Mm-hmm. And there's a forward throw. Trying to read some type of an option, but Larry just let himself drift down, and that was actually super smart. You don't really expect that option too much.
Alrighty, here we go. Oh, okay, another jump fair. Catches on the anti-air.
Mm-hmm. Larry trying to get him with that down tilt because he wants to take out the stock. And that down tilt is such a good option for taking out nice and fast and clean.
Yep, It's a very nice kill move to have. He had it since the melee days. Like, it's still an option.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty, here we go. Fourth throw. Bounce Fish not quite going to work at this percent anymore.
Yeah, and Larry, once again, going in for these dares on his landings. It looks like it works so well.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the low profile on the Phantasm still picks him up. Gets him one more time. Gets that fair.
Oh, no. He had to recover.
Yeah.
Oh, he got a reset off of it, and now Larry's doing marvelous percent, and Charlie going for a dare of his own. Larry probably didn't expect that he air dodged. He was like, whoa, give me a second, I need to breathe.
Yeah, that was really crazy, but here we go, up tilt, no back air this time. Charlie has a second chance of life.
Yep, and there's the needles trying to space himself out. Oh, up air, there we go, there's the confirm.
All right,
actually, a little late, too.
Yeah, Charlie... he had the lead before, but, you know, Larry was able to bring it back, so I don't want to count him out yet. Mm-hmm. But still, he's trying to keep up with the control here.
Yeah, dude. I feel like, to Larry, percent's a number, dude. Like, don't really mean anything. Because he gets you with an up tilt, and you might be eating a bear.
Yeah, but Charlie's doing a good job of making sure he's shielding, make sure he's not putting himself in the position where he's going to get hit by up tilt. He's being very careful how he spot dodges, what defensive option he uses, make sure he doesn't get hit by that hitbox.
Yeah, and it looked like he DI'd it really well because he put him in an after stop where he couldn't get buried. And there's the up air, and now Charlie's doing a lot of percent. And no nair. He's going to catch him with the up smash, and Charlie taking it game five.
Dang. That was crazy. That time around, it looked like he was still keeping up control of the match, and he didn't let himself get reversal by Larry. That was very good for him.
Mm-hmm. Like, he got the two stock advantage, and then he kept